Look here, there and yonder. The world is full of wonder. For all the where and why, hows and the when, what, where's. There's but one place worthy, Achala Bharati. There's but one place worthy, Achala Bharati.
Children, come. Let us listen to the story of Emperor Ashoka, the great king who preached non-violence.
Achala Vismaya Loka, an amazing world of limitless fun. Brought to you by Achala Bharati Trust.
Hello children, I hope all of you are doing very well. I am here today to tell you all a story about one of the greatest emperors who ruled over India. Do you know whom I am talking about? It is none other than Ashoka the Great. He was the son of Bindusara and the grandson of the great ruler Chandragupta Maurya, who was also the founder of the Maurya dynasty. It is said that his mother, Subhadrangi, was extremely happy when she gave birth to her son. And she said, "I am now without sorrow." That is how he came to be called as Ashoka, which means without sorrow. Now let me tell you about his childhood. Ashoka was an extremely brilliant and fearless boy who proved his ability at a very early age. When Ashoka's father, Bindusara, was ill, he appointed his eldest son, Sushima, as the heir to the throne. But the others disliked Sushima and wanted Ashoka to be their king. So after Bindusara's death, a civil war broke out where it is said that Ashoka killed many of his brothers and became the king. So children, the empire which Ashoka inherited was a very large one. Most of the Indian subcontinent came under his rule. The only regions left were the southernmost regions of India and Kalinga. As I told you all earlier, Ashoka's grandfather, Chandragupta Maurya, had founded the dynasty and had expanded it. That is why the only place left for Ashoka to conquer was Kalinga, which was a land rich in minerals and pots. Now children, did you know that the most important event in Ashoka's reign was his conquest of Kalinga, which also happened to be a turning point in his life as well? Alright, so now I'll tell you how this turning point happened. Ashoka and his army emerged victorious after a bloody battle. The bloodshed changed his mind completely. It is said that more than 1 lakh people died in the war and even more from the battle wounds and hunger. Around 1,50,000 soldiers were taken as prisoners as well. Looking at all this, Ashoka did not consider it as a victory. He repented for his cruel action and felt responsible for the loss of so many fellow beings. The Kalinga War made Ashoka renounce war and adopt a policy of peace and non-violence. Finding solace in the teachings of Buddha, he embraced Buddhism. Ashoka began to preach and propagate Buddhism. During those early days, it is said that in his kingdom, many animals used to be killed for food every day. However, after Ashoka became a Buddhist, he stopped this animal slaughter and laid down a code of regulation to restrict the slaughter and utilization of animals throughout the empire. He also preached reverence for parents, teachers, and elders. He strived to provide comfort for men and animals by planting shade-giving and fruit-bearing trees throughout his kingdom. He also got wells dug and built rest houses throughout his kingdom. He preached tolerance towards other religions as well. He worked hard to spread Buddhism far and wide. The most well-known missions relating to Ashoka are those taken by his oldest children, Mahendra and Sangamitra, both of whom had become Buddhist monks. The siblings were requested by Sri Lankan King Devanampriya, who was a contemporary of Ashoka and based at the ancient Sri Lankan capital, Anuradhapura, to spread the teachings of Buddha in his kingdom. It is said that Sangamitra carried with her a branch from Mahabodhi tree in Gaya and planted it in Anuradhapura. The tree that grew from it is worshipped even to this day. Ashoka also built thousands of stupas and viharas throughout the country for peace and welfare of the people and became a noble preacher of dharma. Children, are you all aware of the national emblem of India? Yes, it is the Ashoka pillar. The pillar of Ashoka at Sarnath in the state of Uttar Pradesh was erected by Emperor Ashoka in 250 BC is one of the famous monuments as well. Emperor Ashoka is remembered even today for the service he did to Buddhism, and his name stands out in the history of India. His good deeds earned him names like Dharma Ashoka, meaning pious Ashoka, Devanampriya, meaning the beloved of the gods, Priyadarshi, meaning one who regards everyone in a friendly and a pleasant manner. After ruling for almost 38 years, Ashoka the Great died at the age of 72, and the Mauryan dynasty unfortunately came to an end. So children, this was the story of one of the greatest emperors of India. I hope all of you enjoyed the story just as much as I did by narrating it to you all. Thank you. Bye-bye for now.
It was such an inspiring story, isn't it, children? Please let us know your feedback. Do not forget to tell all your friends about Achala Vismaya Loka. Bye!